Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Now we are going to discuss ESE Engineering Service Examination previous year objective type questions in Electronics and Communication Engineering. I had already completed the part 1 video. In that part 1 video I had discussed around 20 bits. If you don't see that video, please see that video. The video link will be given in the description. Now let us start our session. 21st bit now we are going to discuss. What are the salient features of thermistors? Thermistors, thermocouples, all these are the temperature transducers. Okay, what are the salient features of thermistors? Options are, they are compact, rugged and inexpansive. Second one, they have good stability when properly aged. Third one, the response time of thermistors can vary from a fraction of second to minutes depending on the size of the detecting mass and thermal capacity of the thermistor. What is the correct option? Option D, that is 1, 2 and 3. All these are the salient features of the thermistors. Okay, remember, a thermistor is a temperature transducer. 22. A 1 milliampere meter movement with an internal resistance of 100 ohms is to be converted into a 0 to 100 milliampere ammeter. The value of shunt resistance will be, for your better understandability purpose, for explanation purpose, I had written this formula. We have to calculate the shunt resistance. The formula for the shunt resistance is RSH equal to IM into RM by I minus IM. What is the value of IM? IM means internal resistance. Internal resistance value they had given in the, IM. IM means 1 milliampere. RM. RM is the internal resistance. Sorry, previously I had said IM is the internal resistance. No, it is IM value is 1 milliampere. RM is the internal resistance. Internal resistance value is 100 ohms. I have to substitute 100 ohms. And I, current is 100, current is 100 amperes, and minus IM, 1 milliampere. So we have to substitute, we have to subtract I minus IM, that means 100 minus 1 milliampere. So we have to multiply with 10 power minus 3. In numerator, if you multiply both these, we can get 100 milliampere ohm, and in denominator we can get 99 milliampere. Milliampere, milliampere gets cancelled, and finally 100 by 99 equal to 1.01 ohms. That means option D is the correct one. Okay, next 20. Remember this formula, shunt resistance equal to IM RM by I minus IM, where RM is the internal resistance. 23. The Laplace transform of a function f of t is f of s equal to s plus 2 by s plus 2 whole square plus 10 square. The value of f naught will be, here it is the explanation, f of s equal to s plus 2 by s plus 2 whole square plus 10 square. It is the given. We have to convert this expression into like this, s plus 2 by, we have to expect a plus b whole square, s square plus 4s plus 104. Okay. After that, by applying initial value theorem, 10 square means 100, no? 100 plus 4, 104. By applying initial value theorem, limit s tends to infinity, s into f of s. By applying initial value theorem, we can multiply with s into f of s. After that, we can substitute s equal to infinity. Then apply the limit, s equal to infinity, 2 by 0, that means infinity. And 1 by 0, that is infinity, and 1 by 0, that is infinity. S square gets cancelled, and finally we can get 1. Okay. In this way, we can find out the answer for this question. And next one, a function in the Laplace domain is given by f of s equal to 2 by s minus 1 by s plus 3. Its value by final value theorem in t domain will be, okay, here we have to apply final value theorem. Previously, we had applied initial value theorem, then we can apply final value theorem. limit s tends to 0 s into f of s is the final value theorem. Limit s tends to infinity s into f of s is the initial value theorem. What if given f of s equal to 2 by s minus 1 by s plus 3. Okay, and multiplying we can get this expression s plus 6 by s into s plus 3. We have to multiply with s and apply the limit s equal to 0. Finally, we can get the answer is 2. Okay, limit s tends to 0 s into f of s is equal to limit t tends to infinity f of t equal to 2. Okay, option B is the correct answer. Next, 25th bit. Consider the following experimental readings for a two-port network. This particular bit is related to network analysis. The values of Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22 respectively are. For explanation purpose, I had solved this problem. Z11 equal to V1 by I1 where I2 equal to 0. That means V1 value 100 by I1 value 10 volts. That means we can get 10 ohms. Z21, V2 by I1, V2 value 60 by I1 value, we have to consider 10, 6 ohms. And Z22 equal to V2 by I2, where I1 equal to 0, V2 by I2. That means here we have to consider this column. Okay, V2 by I2, I2 value is 3. Okay, then Z12 equal to V1 by I2 where I1 equal to 0, V1 value equal to 30 and I2 value 3. Finally, we can get 10 ohms. In this way, we have to find out for this answer. The final option is 10 ohms, 10 ohms, 6 ohms and 13.33 ohms. Option A is the correct one. Option A is the correct answer. 26. The Laplace transform of f of t equal to 1 minus e power minus 2t is, and applying Laplace transform f of t will convert it into f of s. Why? Because Laplace transform will be in s domain. Laplace transform of 1 by s minus e power minus 2t 1 by s plus 2. Okay, on cross multiplication we can get 2 by s into s plus 2. So option A is the right answer. Next, 27 and 28. For a two-port network, the condition of a symmetry in terms of Z parameter, the symmetry condition is Z11 equal to Z22. Remember, Z11 equal to Z22 in terms of Z parameters. It is the condition of the symmetry. Similarly, for a two-port network, the condition of reciprocity in terms of H parameter, condition of reciprocity is in terms of H parameters is H12 equal to minus H21. Next, 29. The characteristic impedance of a 80 cm long lossless transmission line having L equal to 0.25 microhenry per meter and C capacitance equal to 100 picofarads per meter will be. We have to find out the characteristic impedance. This particular bit is related to EMT, electromagnetic theory. We have to find out characteristic impedance, that is Z0. Z0 equal to square root of L by C, where L is 0.25 into 0.25 microhenry, that is 0.25 into 10 power 6, and capacitance C equal to 100 into 10 power minus 12. Why? Because picofarads into 10 power minus 12. If you solve this expression, we can get the value is 50 ohms. It is the characteristic impedance. Right? Next, 30. Ground waves progress along the surface of the earth and must be polarized vertically. Okay, option is vertically, not horizontally, not circularly, not elliptically, but the correct answer is vertical. See here, ground waves are vertically polarized waves. Remember always, ground waves are vertically polarized waves using vertical antennas with a small height. Next, 31. A controller that takes control of the buses and transfers data directly between source and destination bypassing the microprocessor is known as DMA, DMA controller, direct memory access. The direct memory access, DMA in between memory and IO without the intervention of the microprocessor. What DMA will do means it will halt the processor for some time. For the transfer of instructions, it will hold the processor for some time. Okay, here it is. You can directly transfer the data between the source and destination bypassing the microprocessor. That means DMA can halt the microprocessor for some time for the transfer of the data. Okay. And 32, add 8 and 9 in BCD code. Okay. 8, you have to consider a decimal number, 8 and 9. You have to add both 8 plus 9 equal to 17. Okay, in decimal value. After that, 1 is, you have to convert into BCD code. Okay. A 7 is written as 011. And 1 is written as 0001. In 8421 code, you have to write like this. In 8421 code, 7 is written as 011, whereas 1 is written as 001. Okay, 17. Next, convert the binary number 11000110 to gray code. We have to convert binary number into the gray code conversion. What we have to do means the MSB bit. It is the MSB bit and it is the LSB bit. Now the MSB bit will be written as it is. Then we have to perform the XOR operation between the previous bit and the current bit. Okay, we have to perform the XOR operation between the previous bit and current bit. The MSB will written as it is. So if you perform the XOR operation between the current between the previous bit and current bit, one XOR one, that is 0. One XOR 0, that is 1. 0 XOR 0, 0, 0 XOR 0, 0, 0 XOR 1, 1, 1 XOR 1, 0, 1 XOR 0, 1. Like this we can get. The correct option is D, option D. The MSB bit will return as it is. Then we have to perform the XOR operation between the previous bit and the current bit. Then we can get binary number transformed into the gray code conversion. Next, 34. The decimal value of the signed binary number 10101010 expressed in 2's complement will be. We have to convert this binary number into 2's complement. What they had given, it is the signed binary number they had given. Here 1 implies it is a negative number that we have to take over minus. First of all, we have to convert this binary number into 2's complement form. Before getting 2's complement form, we have to obtain the 1's complement form. How we can get a 1's complement form? All zeros will transfer into 1 and all 1's will be transformed into zeros. Like this 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. Like this we have to, zeros will be transformed into 1 and 1 will be transformed into zeros. So for this 1's complement, what is 2's complement means 1's complement plus 1. 1 plus 1, that means 0 with the carry 1. Like this way we can get the n value is 86. 86 in the decimal. If you here it represents signed bit, so we have to consider minus. Okay, this value is considered minus 86. Okay, what we have to do means here first of all we have to take out the 1's complement and then we have to add 1 plus for getting the 2's complement. Then we can get the resultant answer. Next, 35 and 36. A transfer function having all its poles and zeros only in the left half of the S-plane is called minimum phase function. See here, a system is said to be minimum phase if it has all finite zeros and poles in the left side of the S-plane. Okay, next one. The frequency where magnitude m has a peak value in frequency response is known as resonant frequency. What resonant frequency will exactly means? Resonant frequency is that at which magnitude of frequency response is maximum. Okay, resonant frequency in which magnitude of the frequency response is the maximum value. Next, 37. Consider the following open loop transfer function. Given transfer function is z equal to k into s plus 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 4. Okay, we have to find out the characteristic equation of a unity negative feedback. Okay, you have to find out the characteristic equation. Consider a characteristic equation q of s equal to 1 plus g of s into h of s equal to 0, where h of s equal to 1. Why? Because they had mentioned unity negative feedback. That means the feedback is 1. That means 1 plus, I have to write down this transfer function. K into s plus 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 4. Okay. By taking LCM, you can get the characteristic equation as s plus 1 into s plus 4 plus k into s plus 2 equal to 0. Option A is the right answer. 38. For the given transfer function g of s equal to y of s by r of s equal to 1 by s square plus 3s plus 2. The response y of t for a step input r of t equal to 5 into a of t will be. Okay, where u of t is the unit step input. For this question, we have to solve like this. Y of s by r of s, it is a transfer function, no? Given transfer function 1 by s square 3s plus 2. Y of s equal to 1 by s square plus 3s plus 2 into r of s. Okay, then we have to convert like this. 1 by s plus 1 into s plus 2. Okay, we have to factorize this to a particular quadratic equation. 1 by s plus 1 into s plus 2. If you take the Laplace transform 5 into u of t, the Laplace transform of 5 into u of t is 5 by s. Okay, unit step function Laplace transform is 1 by s. Then we can get 5 by s here. Then after taking partial fractions, we can get the values of a equal to 5 by 2, b equal to minus 5 and c equal to 5 by 2. Okay, after applying y of t, then y of s will be converted into y of t, then 5 by 2 minus 5 into e power minus t. Why? Because s plus 1 no e power minus t. 5 by 2, c value is 5 by 2, s plus 2 no e power minus 2t into u of t, where u of t is the unit step input. It is self-explanatory. Go through this particular slide if you don't understand. Next, 39. A 360 watt carrier is simultaneously modulated by two audio waves with the modulation percentages of 55 and 65 respectively. The effective modulation index and the total power radiated are. Okay, what they had given in the problem? They had mentioned the carrier power, that means so 360 watt, and modulation index percentages they had given. So we have to divide it 55 by 100 and 65 by 100. So we can get a modulation index V1 equal to 0.55 and mu2 equal to 0.65. Then effective modulation index, what we have to calculate ultimate limit. So modulation index, effective modulation index, for effective modulation index mu2 equal to square root of mu1 square plus mu2 square. If you substitute mu1 and mu2 in this particular expression, we can get 0.85 as the effective modulation index. Then we have to find out the total power also. The total power equal to PT equal to PC into 1 plus mu t square by 2. If you substitute all these values, carrier power will be given. Effective modulation we had already known. If you substitute all these values, we can get 49.5 volts as the total power radiated, and more effective modulation index is 0.85. That means option A is the right correct one. Then we have to see the last bit, that is 40. A source produces three symbols A, B and C with probabilities P of A equal to 1 by 2, P of B equal to 1 by 4 and P of C equal to 1 by 4, the source entropy. This particular bit is belongs to digital communications, then particularly information theory. Okay, what they had mentioned, probabilities P of A equal to 1 by 2, P of B equal to 1 by 4, P of C equal to 1 by 4. We have the one formula in digital communications for entropy, that is H equal to sigma pi into log of 1 by pi, where I value equal to 3. Why? Because A, B, C. If you substitute I value 1 by 2, that means P of A, that means P1 it is. P1 equal to 1 by 2, P2 equal to 1 by 4 and P3 equal to 1 by 4. If you substitute all these values, log 2 base 2, if you substitute all these values and solve this, we can get 1 into 1 by 2 bits per symbol as the entropy for this particular question. Okay, 1 into 1 by 2, it is a 2. 1 into 1 by 2 bits per symbol, it means option D is the correct answer. It is 1 into 1 by 4 it is. Okay, it is not correct one. 1 into 1 by 2 bits per symbol is the entropy. source entropy for this particular question. Thank you.